Oh, that was a lot.
I challenge you to try and spot the crew throughout the show, and also to spot Shelley, beautifully modelled by Ricky from the Kaiser Chiefs.
There he is.
Shelley, but can you see her later in the show?
The happy dance, everyone. That can only mean one thing. Mate, well done. That looked really tough.
It was really tough, but thank you to Nick and Lucy for being an absolutely awesome team. Now, though, on to the big... But in fact, before I even talk about the big badge wall, if you want to see a behind-the-scenes of what I got up to, jump online and see me with Lucy. I said she was awesome. There she is there. Now, though, onto the big badge wall, which is equally as awesome. And to help model the next piece of post, Ricky from the Kaiser Chiefs, what have you got there, my friend?
Check this out, Radzi. It's your hair when you did that world record.
Yes!
Very cool.
And it's been provided for me by Hannah. She's 11, she's from Buckinghamshire, and for her efforts... sterling efforts. She's won a Blue Peter Badge, as have all these dudes.
Yes.
You should keep that, by the way, so good luck.
Well, it depends on what Hannah says about that.
OK, fine. Hannah, thank you very much. Henry, who's 7 from Darlington, has sent this picture in. It's Iggy, made out of little bits of scrumped-up paper that have been painted and glued over with Iggy's name. It's absolutely brilliant. And as you can see, Iggy here is discovering the laws of gravity. You've got a Blue Peter Badge. Congratulations. On the way to you.
Yes, and Anna from London has made her own game, which is pretty incredible. It's called the Earn Your Badges game. You have to collect the coins to earn the badges, but don't get hit by the boots because you'll have a basket on your head. And she's earned a big blue badge for herself. Good job.
Good job indeed, Dan. I think we've got another question for you.
Okay, go ahead.
Hi, Dan. My name's Kate, and this is my question for you. If you were locked inside a sponge cake, squished in between jam and cream, plus you had a lizard with you, what would you do? Thanks.
Great question.
That is possibly the most random question I've ever been asked. So I would team up with the lizards, see if he wanted the jam bit or the cream bit, and then we'd just make our way out from there. That's how we do this.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Right, well, listen, while you're doing that and asking questions later on, I'm talking about cakes. Do you know why? Because Quartz Disco Gorilla, Cyan Glittery Toad and White Piano 11 have got in touch. It's impossible, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they want to see more bakes on the show. So I'm eating some we made earlier. Very exciting. Head to the website if you want to find out how to make your own gooey chewies. And while you're there, you can make a speaker for your mobile phone using loo roll and also a cup. It's really cool. Check it out. There's the details that you need. And that's inspired by Megan from Wolves, by the way.
Love Wolverhampton, my neck of the woods. Now, though, it's time for what's fast becoming my favourite part of the show, when we announce the Blue Peter Fan of the Month. And in this month of October, Lindsay, would you give us a hand with some friends of the show?
I've got my glamorous assistants here. They're ready to go. So for being so dedicated on the Blue Peter website, for being lovely to other fans, the Blue Peter Fan of the Month is... Go on, guys. VP superfans, but don't just take my word for it. Thanks, Ollie. Thank you.
I will never get bored of hearing Lindsay doing an impression of Shelley. Now then, Purple Piano Toucan, you'll be very happy indeed because you said you'd like to see more live music on the show. Well, would you please welcome to Blue Peter, the Kaiser Chiefs! Hey!
Yes, my friend. We're back, folks!
It's been 2 years.
It has been 2 years.
What have you been up to?
I've been waiting for Purple Piano Toucan to get in touch and bring us back. So we've been waiting.
Has it been worth the wait?
We've been waiting, but yes, because we've been working on new stuff and we're excited about it.
And tomorrow's a very special day.
It's all coming out tomorrow and it's like, it's been nerve-wracking. It's like waiting for your homework to come back and seeing what mark you get.
I got a D always. Well...
D for dangerously good.
That's very good. Well, Ricky, you guys look ready to go, so thank you so much for being...
OK, we'll get ready. Hang on. Here's the thing, because someone's been in touch. Lemon Crunchy Mayfly's been in touch, and she's asked... You'll get this, guys. She wants me to crack an egg onto your head, Radzi.
What?
I know. You've got to do it. Lemony Crunchy Mayfly wants us to do it.
This was not in the script, but for the fan club...
For the kids,
anything.
Guys. Right, OK, anything. You ready? You ready? Oh, it won't be hard. It'll just be a bit soft. It's made of rubber, everybody.
Hey!
Hey, catch my name. Hey! Catch camera three. Hey! Ooh, really?
Close.
Yeah, but also, Slate Grey Smiley Puffin wants to get in touch and say, can we do more practical jokes? So that's a practical joke right there.
You ask, we deliver. Oh, I missed the... Got it! Yes, got it!
That's hand. A challenge. Catch the egg.
It's right.
Itself a great big house.
everybody signed up to the Blue Peter fan club again. And took it all from the top, the top, the top, the top. There's a hole in my soul that could only be filled by you again. From the top again. Take it all from the top, the top, the top, the top.